Вот. You void Synthesizer by Machine Girl. This album came really unexpected to me. There was no promotion or anything as far as I'm aware. It just dropped on February 26, 2020, and I've been listening to it fairly often since. To be honest, I expected Mark 90 Mix Volume 2 to be released before another full-length album, since we've already got some tracks from that, but I'm not complaining. Now, I might be dumb, but I completely missed some reference if there is any, but the name You Void Synthesizer doesn't mean anything to me. The artwork of the album is great though. It might not be among my personal favorite designs, but it represents the sound of the album perfectly. It's nasty, it's gritty, it's intense and over the top. As a whole, this album reminds me a lot of the Ugly Art, their previous full-length album, but better. I remember rating the Ugly Art pretty well in my review, but I haven't been listening to that album much since then. And it was one of the reasons why I decided to get rid of the numerical scores in my reviews. Opinions change. So I just really hope that You Void Synthesizer will stick with me longer, because I've been seeking the Machine Girl for quite a while now as a fan of digital hardcore that thinks Machine Girl is one of the best examples of it. The band's sound and the sound direction leans way more towards some electro-fucked punk rock, but it's still a pretty damn good sound. In fact, I think I could say that You Void Synthesizer took the core sound of the Ugly Art and perfected it with new tricks. One of the downsides in the Ugly Art for me was that the newly incorporated live drums sounded nice, but they took away the punchiness of the bassy electronic ones. Not in this album. This time around, the mixing feels way better, and the drums are amazingly complemented by some distortion effects and bass synths. I just love the sound texture in this album. Song structure is another question. Let's get into those one by one. Right from the first listen, I knew this was going to be good, but not instantly easy to get into. Most of the sounds in this album, starting with the very first song, have been altered beyond recognition, and I literally can't tell if I'm hearing some nasty sounding synth or a real distorted actual guitar, but I like it either way. I like the general melody and the instrumental of the song, but I'm not that sure about vocals. Ever since, because I'm young, arrogant, and hate everything you stand for, Machine Girl started using original vocals instead of just samples, and the voice is definitely not for everyone. It took me a while to get used to it, and I can see that it can get annoying to some people. But even then, The Fortress is among my favorite songs in the album, because it just seems to be one of the most memorable and catchy ones. Blood Magic feels like a leftover from the Ugly Art, sonically, but if you enjoyed that album, you get to go for round two, and it's not sloppy at all. It also has a sample that says scum a lot. I appreciate that. Oncoming. I really like the low, gnarly, barely understandable vocals in the intro of the song. The hook of the song is also pretty killer, but everything in between feels a bit like a continuation of the previous song and is ultimately a bit forgettable to me. Now, if Oncoming felt like a continuation of Blood Magic, Fortress Destroyer is pretty much a part 2 of the Blood Inside the Fortress, and I like it a lot. It's a way slower and trippier than the previous songs. I've seen someone call these slower Machine Girl songs filler before, but I disagree with that completely. They are some of my favorite ones, and this particular one must be the nastiest of them. It doesn't overstay its welcome either, as it's shorter than 2 minutes. This one I like. I'm usually not a huge fan of guest musicians, but in this album they really work well. Scroll of Sorrows reintroduced some of those brighter sounding synths that I loved in earlier Machine Girl music, and the female vocals make the song even better. If I had to sum up the song with one sentence, I'd say it sounds like a late 90s website that is possessed by a lusty demon. Splatter! Exclamation mark. It is quite the wall of noise. It's very intense all the way through. It does have some of that brighter sound again in the chorus, and it honestly feels like a moment of solitude before diving into a pool of audio, blood and razors again. I'm not saying it's bad, you just need a taste for the extreme. Kill All Borders 2020 Worldwide Fucker. What a great title. I'd named the entire album Worldwide Fucker, I like it so much. The song has a very strict and straight-to-the-point sound compared to all the others in this album, and sometimes, like in this case, such simplicity is welcome. The song is only 1.5 minutes long, but it's a blast. Quite literally, actually. Devil's Peak is probably the most somber sounding song in the album. The timing for it is great after several really intense bits. And I by no means am saying that this song doesn't sound hardcore, the whole album does. While Devil's Peak is a bit lighter, it still sounds like something an action movie would use as a soundtrack for its most intense shootout scene. The song is genuinely great. You know, with this song, this album's greatest flaw starts sticking out. At this point I'm listening to the album for quite a while, and it's hard to concentrate on all the details after so much time. And with the way most songs in the album are so fast and intense, they start just bleeding into one big mess of noise and become a bit forgettable. Aside from several parts of it, I honestly can barely remember the song even after listening to it multiple times. Despite a really dumb title, Suck Shit is among my favorite tracks in the album. The first half of the song is a bit meh, but when the guest vocals by Lustig Puppy and Rafia kick in, I hope I pronounced it right, it gets really good. I think it would be one of my favorite songs in a long time if the whole song was like that. It's just that with those softer female vocals, the song becomes more melodic, forming a really stubborn earworm in my brain. I keep singing the line, "I'll end your fucking gas, it's not a threat, it's a fact," to myself for days. Well done. This song actually made me check out who the guest vocals were. Battle Forever is also an amazing song and definitely in my top 3 in this album, together with Suck Shit and The Fortress. It pretty much comes in two parts again. The first one reminds me of those Japanese kaiju movies. You know, the ones where they fight the giant monsters like Tetsuo, the Iron Man or Zeram. Godzilla for fuck's sake. It's just that the slower vocals and synths have a really epic feel to them. And while the first half is truly great, The second one is just as good. It becomes its own thing, really, as it sounds completely different. It just gets very fast, but it sounds unlike all the fast songs that came before it. It reminds me of older Machine Girl songs, but sped up, which is not a bad sound at all. I find the drop after the slower part very satisfying every time. So, all in all, I can definitely give U-Boy Synthesizer by Machine Girl thumbs up. I'm just unsure yet if the album is just good or very good. I'll just have to see how it stands against the test of time. As I said, the sound direction in this album is just great. It's exactly what I enjoy. It's just that some of the songs just melt into a pot of intensity for me. I'm aware that this is the point of Machine Girl, to make the sound as over the top as possible, but I'm afraid that after the initial excitement about good new music, I might not want to listen to the album that much. Let's hope that doesn't happen, and the album grows on me even more. I mean, there are albums that I was excited for that came out this year, but I chose to review this one because this one evoked the strongest emotions in me. But yeah, the more digital hardcore music, the better. Anyway, thank you for listening to my crappy opinion for so long, and goodbye.